This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program, or for more details.
And you have a double declining balance. So double declining balance is double of the declining balance. Okay. So it is like usually thought like it's a double. So you have a factor is two. Okay, so the double declining balance, if you see, okay, and we see the help, okay, on this function. So the double declining balance, it returns the depreciation using the double declining method. Okay, so there is a concept of factor there. Okay, so the factor is optional. By default, the factor is two. Okay, so double declining, don't think that the depreciation will be two times. Okay, think this way, the depreciation will be the decline will be happening at a rate of 2. Okay, so this is one example I have, DDB. So you see DDB, what it takes? It takes the cost. So this is the cost, salvage value, life, and the period in which you are computing the depreciation. If you don't give factor, it takes 2 as a factor. So you see this depreciation was 1000. I will make it 2. It remains as 1000. Even if I drag this, it remains the same. So that means by default factor is taken as 2, and you see what is happening here. Okay. So what is the decline in the depreciation? So you see, so here first year is 1000, next year is 800. Okay. So 200 is a decline. Okay. Okay. So you see 640. Okay. If I compute a ratio, 800 by 1000, 0.8. How you get 0.8? 1 minus, or let's say, 0.8. Okay, it is, okay, just 1 minute. Factor of 2.5. Okay, see this. Okay, so this factor, you can see this way, this is 1 minus 2 by 10. Okay, so that is how it is. So declining is 2. So the ratio of the depreciation of the first year to the second year will be 0.8. So which is 1 minus 2 by 10. So see third year, it is like this all depreciation is 0.8, 0.8, 0.8 times. Okay. So because of this, it may happen that you may not have covered the entire depreciation. See, it is all at a ratio of 0.8, 0.8. And if I compute the depreciation for this entire year, it is only coming 4463. Okay. It may happen that if you choose a factor, it may not cover the entire depreciation. Okay. If your salvage value is very less. Okay. If your salvage value is, let's say, large, let's say 1000, okay, probably I have covered. See, these two are zero. But if your salvage value is very less, okay, your double declining balance may not cover the entire depreciation. Okay, so in 500 also it is not covering, right? So in 1000 it has, see, in 1000 double declining balance has covered. Okay. So what is this factor and who decides this factor? Mostly the finance department will decide the factor. Okay, if there's a government regulation around it, that factor will be taken. Okay. Now the double declining balance, if I do it with a factor of 5, okay, so this is same calculation I am doing with a factor of 5. So the decline is, see, it becomes 0.5, 5 by 10. It becomes 5 by 10, 5 by 10. Okay, so your decline, that is what I am saying, is that it will be, so 1 minus 5 by 10 factor is, so that is come as 0.5. Okay. Now here you will see that when factor is very high, there is no depreciation in the later part of the years. Okay. You have depreciated it fully. So a higher factor will result in higher depreciation. That is the idea. Lower factor will result in lower depreciation. Is it making sense? If I make it a factor of, let's say, 2.5. So 2.5, how we'll get this ratio? We'll get 1 minus 2.5 by 10. So 0.75 as the ratio has come. So this is like not factor of 3, it is factor of 2.5. Okay. So this is a calculation we have given fed a factor of 2.5. And again, we see that this double declining balance, it is not resulting in a full depreciation. Right? So do you think it's a good method? Yes, it is a good method. It is depreciating higher amount at the start. But there is one drawback. If the salvage value is less, okay, it may not depreciate fully. Okay, that is the problem. Okay. So what could be the solution? Anybody, can you think of anybody? What could be the solution? You are not depreciating fully in the 10 years. What can be done? One thing we can do is, okay, in the later part of the years, we can increase the depreciation. We can increase the depreciation and make it such a way that at the end of 10 years, the depreciation will be fully covered. Okay.
This video is part of the certification program, SABA, Spreadsheet Applications in Business Analytics. Please contact if you want to apply for the certificate program or for more details.